Hello and welcome from the dSPACE virtual showroom. My name is Fabian Engelmann and today I want to talk about high bandwidth data logging. If you want to run a successful data acquisition campaign, you're going to need a reliable hardware, a reliable data logging platform, which can satisfy your needs in terms of high bandwidth. But what kind of bandwidth is actually needed for autonomous driving applications? This, of course, depends on your sensor's configurations. So let us just make an example calculation for that. Let us focus on camera sensors, since in AD applications, they usually generate the highest data weights. So what data weight is produced by a single high-resolution camera? Let's assume the following. Let's take a 4K camera with this resolution, which has a frame rate of 60 frames per second and 12 bit per pixel. So if we now multiply everything together, we get the number of pixels, then multiply this with 12 to get the number of bit per frame, and multiply it with 60 to get the number of bits per second. So calculating this, we end up with around 6 gigabit per second for a single high resolution camera. In AD projects, you're not gonna have one, but multiple camera sensors. If we take a look, Tesla, for example, say that they're using 8 camera sensors. So if we just take 8 cameras, we're not gonna end up at 6, but we're gonna end up at 48 gigabit per second. And this is, of course, still neglecting whatever bandwidth you need for all your the other sensors. So for radar, LiDAR, ultrasonic, IMUs, GPS sensors, and further on. So as you can see, for AD data logging applications, you're gonna need a bandwidth of up to or even above 50 gigabit per second. So you can see the requirements for a data logging platform. We as dSPACE always aim to have the best possible solution on the market. We don't shy away from any challenges or high technical requirements. We are future-proof and guarantee you a logging bandwidth of constantly above 50 gigabit per second. So today, let us put this promise to a test. Let me show you that we can constantly log data with more than 50 gigabit per second with our data logging solution, the AUTERA platform. In this AUTERA AUTOBOX, I've got two of our data storage units built in, and each of them has one SSD inside. To get above 50 gigabit per second, I'm using these six Ethernet 10 gigabit Ethernet interfaces. To also easily control and scale up the setup, I'm generating virtual UDP packages to be recorded. For this, another high-performance hardware with many 10 gigabit interfaces is needed. And since we're dSPACE, the easiest solution for me is just to use another AUTERA AUTOBOX for this. As a software to generate the packages, there are many possibilities. I use currently a small program called MoonGen. This is quite performant and can generate random UDP packages for all of the six 10 gigabit Ethernet interfaces. So now let us have a look at the software. So here you can see the screen of the recording AUTERA. This is the storage location where I want to store all the logged data. Here for the first SSD and for the second. As a software to do the high performance logging and timestamping, we use ATMAPS. ATMAPS stands for Real-Time Multi-Sensor Application and is a highly efficient framework for asynchronous data processing. This is the diagram which I have prepared. This Ethernet capture package is doing all the heavy lifting. All the other components are just for visualization purposes. In this block, I defined which Ethernet interfaces to capture, and also I define the storage location and data formats. This also outputs some numerical statistics on the recorded data. So now let me turn on this diagram. So while this program now needs a moment to connect to all the Ethernet interfaces, let me explain all the graphics which have popped up. Firstly, I have this gauge. This shows the current overall data throughput in gigabit per second. Secondly, I'm plotting the stored gigabyte of each of the SSDs respectively. And thirdly, I visualize some of the numerical information which are coming from the Ethernet capture block. So now initialization is complete and we're listening to whatever data comes over the Ethernet cables. So how does it look like when we're sending data? I will just remotely start the sending program from here. So in this console, I'm already connected via SSH to the sending AUTERA. This is the directory where this moongen program is lying. So now if I start this command, this will start sending simple UDP packages through all of these 6 Ethernet interfaces at a rate of 10 gigabit per second each. This again will need a moment to grab all the Ethernet interfaces. So as you can now observe, we are now sending 6 times 10 gigabit per second. As you can see on this gauge, the current throughput has gone through the roof and is now showing constantly a logging bandwidth of 57 gigabit per second. Also, this plot now shows the constant growth of the stored data. Also, we are storing an equal amount on each of the SSDs. Furthermore, let's look at these statistics. Firstly, you can see the overall number of received Ethernet frames. As you can see, this is a huge number which is constantly rising. Secondly, you can see the total number of dropped UDP packages. As you can see, none of them is being lost. Thirdly, you can see the filling level of the internal buffer in the RAM. As you can see, the buffer is constantly zero. So that means that our writing speed constantly is exceeding the data rate of the incoming data. This means that our AUTERA AutoBox has enough CPU power, and also it shows that ATmaps is efficient and can split up the load onto the 12 CPU cores. Let me now show you that we're not faking anything. Let me just pull some of the cables. So here in the receiving AUTERA, I will just unplug this Ethernet interface. And as you can see in the gauge, the throughput is of course going down. Let me just unplug another one. And the immediate effect again is that we now have a data rate with less than 40 gigabit per second. Okay, let me just put them in again. First one and the second one. And this now needs a moment. But as you can see, the data rate is now rising again to over 57 gigabit per second. Let me shut off this test now. So now after this test, let me shortly show you the stored data on the system. Here you can see that we have stored files of over 200 gigabyte of data on each of the SSDs. Of course, one of the files every time is a little bit less because of me pulling the cable. So as you can see, we are able to continuously capture data with over 57 gigabit per second using 2 of the AUTERA SSDs. But what is the actual limit? What is the maximum writing speed of when I just use 1 of the AUTERA SSDs? To show you that we're not faking anything, let me actually unplug one of them now. Let us try the exact same setup again, with me generating 60 gigabit per second, but this time lock everything onto only 1 SSD. But this time, let me also monitor how long the test is actually running. I must now change the storage location inside ATmaps. So change everything in here to DSU1, Data Storage Unit 1. So let me start the ATmaps program again. This of course now again needs some time for initialization. Also, I need to start the sending program remotely again using this command. But first, let's wait until the initialization is finished. So now I'm starting to send data again. Must start the clock at the right time. There we go. So as you can see, I'm again sending data with 60 gigabit per second. So what you can observe in the plot, that this time we only have one line in here, which means that I'm only collecting data on one SSD. Also, you can see the current data throughput. Here, with one SSD, I'm able to collect 36 gigabit per second continuously. So here you can see what we can do with only one SSD. And we can put two of them in one AUTERA system. Let me now also check the statistic of the Ethernet frames. So here you can see that I've now collected above 9 million Ethernet packages on each of the interfaces. Also, you can see the number of frames which we are missing, which we are not able to store on the SSD in time. Also, you can see the high filling rate in the buffer. As expected, we are not able to write all the data fast enough this time. So now let me turn off everything again. So now after this test, let me do the check. We have now collected data for roughly 90 seconds at a rate of roughly 35 gigabit per second. So if we now calculate everything together, we should have around 400 gigabyte of stored data. Let's check what we actually have. So here you can see that in the six files I've collected, we have around 430 gigabyte of data. So this roughly matches our calculation. So as you could see today, a high bandwidth is needed for data logging for autonomous driving applications. dSPACE can provide you the hardware platform with enough CPU power and flexibility. Also, we can give you a software which is highly efficient for data logging. We don't just claim to have the highest bandwidth in the market, we can back it up.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.